Mary Hamilton's to the kirk again, with ribbons in her hair. And the king thought mair of Mary Hamilton than ony that was there. Mary Hamilton's to the kirk again, with ribbons at her breast. And the king thought mair of Mary Hamilton than he listened to the priest. Mary Hamilton's to the kirk again, with ribbons in her hand. And the king thought mair of Mary Hamilton than the queen in all her land. She hadn't been about the king's court a month, but barely in, when she was beloved by all the king's court, and the king the only man. She hadn't been about the king's court a month, but barely three, when for the king's court Mary Hamilton durstna be. The king is to the abbey gane, to poo the abbey tree and scale the babe for Mary's heart, but the thing it wouldna be. She's rowed it in her apron, and she's set it in the sea, saying, "Gae sink ye or swim, ye bonny babe, he's get nae mair o' me." But word is to the kitchen gane, and word is to the hall, that Mary Hamilton's brought to bed, and the bonny babe's missed in a wa'. For scarce had she lain doon again, and scarcely fa'n asleep, when up there started your good queen, and stood at her bed's feet, saying, "Where's your babe, Mary Hamilton? For I'm sure I heard it greet." Oh no, my noble queen, think nae sic thing to be. 'Twas but a stitch into my side, and sair it troubled me. Get up, Mary Hamilton. Get up and follow me, for I am gone to Edinburgh toon, a rich wedding for to see." Oh, slowly, slowly raised she up, and slowly put she on, and slowly rade she out the way, where money's a weary grown. "Ride hooly, hooly, gentlemen, ride hooly noo wi' me, for never I'm sure a wearier bird rade in your company." The queen was clad in scarlet, her merry maids all in green, and ilka toon that they passed through took Mary for the queen. "Why weep ye so, ye burgess wives? Why look ye so on me? For I am gone to Edinburgh toon, a rich wedding for to see." But little wist Mary Hamilton, when she raid on the brown, that she was gone to Edinburgh town, ought to be put down. For when she rade through the nether bow porch, she laughed, loud laughters three, but lang ere she came by again, the tears blinded her ee. When she gaed up the tall booth steps, the corks fae her heels did flee, but lang ere she came doon again, she was condemned to die.
Ah, but she was the queer old skelsha anyhow, and Olivia trink and told. And sure he was the queer old bunce too, dear dirty dumpling, who's the father of Fingals and Daffergills. Daffer and Gammer were all their gangsters. Hadn't he seven dams to wive him, and every dam had her seven crutches, and every crutch had its seven hues, and each hue had a differing cry, suds for me and supper for you, and the doctor's bill for George on.
The first reaction of readers was predictable. Complete bafflement. Some suspected a hoax. Others wondered if the writing of Ulysses had softened Joyce's brain. Even Miss Weaver, who had applauded Joyce's experiments in Ulysses, was appalled by his latest efforts.
Not exactly, as it were, engaged, but going to be, there is no question.
Oh, Fanny, that's wonderful, because you see his very presence, coming here to live with us, beneath this roof,
and under the most mysterious circumstances. Almost, you see, as if he...
Fanny, what's he said?
What do you mean?
I mean, what's he said?
Don't ask me what he said, my dear, if you'd only seen his look.
Was it like this?
Like that?
John looked at me like that.
Well, so did he, like that, entirely, only rather more genteel.
Well, then that's it.
That's more.
He must mean something. If he looked like that, he must feel something very strong.
Oh, I'm so jealous of you, Tilda.
Light breaks where no sun shines, where no seas run, the waters of the heart push in their tide, and broken ghosts with glowworms in their heads, the things of light file through the flesh where no flesh decks the bones. A candle in the thighs warms youth and seed and burns the seeds of age. Where no seed stirs, the fruit of man unwrinkles in the stars, bright as a fig. Where no wax is, the candle shows its hairs. Dawn breaks behind the eyes, from poles of skull and toe, the windy blood slides like a sea. Nor fenced nor staked, the gushers of the sky spout to the rod, divining in a smile the oil of tears. Night in the socket browns like some pitch moon the limits of the globes. Day lights the bone. Where no cold is, the skinning gales unpin the winter's robes. The film of spring is hanging from the lids. Light breaks on secret lots, on tips of thought where thoughts smell in the rain. When logics die, the secret of the soil grows through the eye, and blood jumps in the sun. Above the waste allotment, the dawn halts.
Sometimes a night funeral going by carries home a cool bop daddy. Hearse and flowers guarantee he'll never hype another patty. It's hard to believe, but dead in there, he'll never lay a hype nowhere. He's my ace boy, gone away. Wake up and live, he used to say. Squares who couldn't dig him, plant him now. Out where it makes no diff nohow. I play it cool and dig all jive. That's the reason I stay alive. My motto as I live and learn is dig and be dug in return.
Christopher Marlowe or Francis Bacon? The author of Lear remains unshaken. Willie Herbert or Mary Fitton? What does it matter? The sonnets were written.
Deep in our subconscious, we are told, lie all our memories, lie all the notes of all the music we have ever heard, and all the phrases those we loved have spoken. Sorrows and losses time has since consoled, family jokes, outmoded anecdotes, each sentimental souvenir and token, everything seen, experienced, each word addressed to us in infancy, before we could even know or understand the implications of our wonderland. There they all are. The legendary lies, the birthday treats, the sights, the sounds, the tears. Forgotten debris of forgotten years, waiting to be recalled. Waiting to rise before our world dissolves before our eyes. Waiting for some small, intimate reminder, a word, a tune, a known familiar scent, an echo from the past when, innocent, we looked upon the present with delight. And doubted not the future would be kinder, and never knew the loneliness of night.
I am Ireland. I am Ireland. I am older than the old woman of Bear. Great my glory, I that bore Cuchulainn the valiant. Great my shame, my own children that sold their mother. I am Ireland. I am lonelier than the old woman of Bear. And here is the same poem in its own language. Misha Eire, Shinnemen an Chalyach Beire, Moor Mogloir, Medorug Kuchalan Kroge, Moor Manair, Machlan Fen the Yeel Mair. Misha Eire, Uegne men an Chalyach Beire.
By the people, of the people. That is one of the biggest faults that could ever be made. Rude. If the lady wasn't in the room, which I don't think is necessary, my body at present have cigar burns, cigarette burns all over it. My testicles at times bother me now from cigarette butts, sticks, rifles. Laying on the table with my head.
Slim in hell. Slim Greer went to heaven. St. Peter said, Slim, you've been a right good boy. And he winked at him. You've been a traveling rascal in your day. You can roam once more. Then you comes to stay. Put these wings on your shoulders and save your feet. Slim grin, and he speak up, thank you, Pete. Then Peter say, go to hell and see all that is doing and report to me. Be sure to remember how everything go. Slim say, I be seeing you on the late watch, Bo. Slim got to cavortin, swell as you choose, like Lindy in the spirit of St. Louis blues. He flew and he flew till at last he hit a hangar with the sign reading, this is it. Then he parked his wings and strolled around, getting used to his feet on the solid ground. Big bloodhound come a-roaring like Niagara Falls, sicked on by white devils in overhauls. Now Slim wa'n't scared, cross my heart, it's a fact, and the dog went on a-baying some po' devil's track. Then Slim saw a mansion and walked right in. The devil looked up with a sickly grin. Certainly didn't look for you, Mr. Greer. How it happened you comes to visit here? Slim say, oh, just thought I'd drop by a spell. Feel at home, sir. And here's the keys to hell. Then he took Slim around and showed him people raising hell as high as the first church steeple. Lots of folks fighting at the roulette wheel, like old Rampart Street or leastwise Beale. Showed him bawdy houses and cabarets, Slim thought of New Orleans and Memphis days. Each devil was busy with a devilish broad, and Slim cried, Lordy, Lord, Lord, Lord. Took him in a room where Slim seed a preacher with a brown skin on each knee. Showed him giant stills going everywhere with a passel of devils stretched dead drunk there. Then he took him to the furnace that some devils was firing, hot as hell, and Slim start a mean perspiring. White devils with pitchforks threw black devils on. Slim thought he'd better be getting along. And he say, this makes me think of home, Vicksburg, Little Rock, Jackson.
Called gerontology, or springtime for senility. At 40, I lost my illusions. At 50, I lost my hair. At 60, my hope and teeth were gone, and my feet were beyond repair. At 80, life has clipped my claws. I'm bent and bowed and cracked. But I can't give up the ghost because my follies are all intact.
We have a thought for the year by our old friend Yip Harburg. Democracy gives us a choice of which machine to vote with, or choose which brand of razor blade you'd rather cut your throat with.
I've whittled my wit and whipped my rhymes for a small obit in the New York Times.
Sometimes a night funeral going by carries home a cool bop daddy. Hearse and flowers guarantee he'll never hype another patty. It's hard to believe, but dead in there, he'll never lay a hype nowhere. He's my ace boy, gone away. Wake up and live, he used to say. Squares who couldn't dig him, plant him now. Out where it makes no diff nohow. I play it cool and dig all jive. That's the reason I stay alive. My motto as I live and learn is dig and be dug in return.
It's called gerontology, or springtime for senility. At 40, I lost my illusions. At 50, I lost my hair. At 60, my hope and teeth were gone, and my feet were beyond repair. At 80, life has clipped my claws. I'm bent and bowed and cracked. But I can't give up the ghost because my follies are all intact.
We have a thought for the year by our old friend Yip Harburg. Democracy gives us a choice of which machine to vote with, or choose which brand of razor blade you'd rather cut your throat with.
I've whittled my wit and whipped my rhymes for a small obit in the New York Times.
Told them when the war had first begun, how to save the Union the way it should be won. But old Kentucky swore so hard, and AB had his fears, till every hope was lost but the colored volunteer. McClellan went to Richmond, 200,000 brave. He said, keep back the niggers, I will say. Little Mackie had his way, the Union's still in tears. Now they call for the help of the colored volunteers. Oh, give us a flag, oh, free without a slave. We'll fight to defend it as our fathers did so brave. Gallant Company A, we'll make those rebels dance. We'll stand by the Union, we only get our chance. Oh, Jeff says he will hang us, we dare to meet him armed. A very big thing, but we were not alarmed. But first he'll have to catch us, before his way is clear. That is what's the matter with the colored volunteer. So rally, boys, rally, let us never mind the past. We've had a hard road to travel, but our day has come at last. God is for the right, and we have no need to fear. The Union will be saved by the colored volunteer. Oh, give us a flag, oh, free without a slave. Fight to defend it that the fathers did so brave. The Gallant Company A will make those rebels dance. We'll stand by the Union, we only had a chance. We'll stand by the Union, we only had our chance.